Hi, welcome back. So in the last video, we actually finished CSS. I mean, the amount of CSS that you should know through a course. And obviously you'll learn much more when you start making projects. And in fact, we are going to make a project in this video. We're gonna start with a code along, and this will go on for two videos because this will actually require you to learn some new things like Google Fonts and some properties of CSS. And this is your first CSS project, so it will take time for you to build it. And the reason this is a code along and not an assignment, so first of all, code along is somewhere that I'll give you the solution side by side, and it's your choice if you want to try it by yourself. But honestly, I've included a lot of things that you don't know until now, right? So you could try searching the web for it and give it a lot of time, and while that will be helpful, I've chosen to make this a code along, and you can just follow along with what I'm doing, and then you'll be easily able to remember all the CSS. Plus, this is your first project in CSS, and this is not that easy. Like, I've used some good things in here. So to show you what this is, not to scare you, this is actually easy. We are not going to use a whole lot of properties. But you don't have experience with CSS right now, and that is why it would be difficult for you to actually determine which property is determining which thing on the page by the first look. You would be able to do that once you've made three or four good looking projects, but before that it's not that easy, right? So this is what we're gonna make. We're gonna make a simple page, but it is going to be well styled, right? If this is what we're gonna make, right? So this is a heading right here. This is a line. This line is something you don't know how to put, right? Then you have an image. And then we have some text. And while this is not a very complex structure, you would be easily able to figure out the HTML behind this. But figuring out how to get it formatted like this, we can see the text is center aligned, and it is center, and you have space here, right? And we have space here, and we see this small shadow kind of thing here. See the background differences. It's quite small. I'm not sure if it's visible on screencast, but if you see here on this edge right here, you can see that the background is a little grayish while this is a little white. So, you know, there I'm using a lot of good things, and these are the kind of things that you would use in a good front end website normally, right? So the first thing I want to show you is this. I will link to this in the description. This is the blog that I've taken the content from, and I've taken like these paragraphs, right? And I've pasted them here to make something that looks a little nice, right? You could make anything once you can make this, because we will cover a lot of the major concepts. We will cover the fonts thing. You can see the fonts are not the same as the default HTML fonts, right? So we are going to introduce a new thing in this video too, which is known as Google Fonts. So yeah, let's start. Okay. So the first things first, when you have a design, which looks simple, so the first thing that you can do is that you can put all the content on the page, and you can leave the styling for later. That's actually how I've made this page for showing you, right? In what I made the HTML first. So I'm now going to name this CSS solution1.html, and now I'm going to get my normal HTML boilerplate. Here it is, and now I'll just indent everything, right? So the first thing is the title, always, which is Harry Potter. Now I've taken this for Harry Potter. You could do this for any movie, of course, that's not a very big problem. But as long as you're able to get this kind of a structure where you have this paragraph, then you have two subheadings and then some content under them, then you're fine, right? It doesn't matter which movie you're taking, obviously. So yeah, so the first thing we can see we have here is this heading. And this is the main heading of the page, so this will go inside our H1, right? What I'm doing right now is I'm going a little fast because this is simple HTML, and I'm sure you would be able to do this. However, if you're not, you will be able to figure out what I'm doing really fast, because we've studied all of this, right? So the next is the image. So now you see this image. One thing you could do is you could go to Google and search for Harry Potter, and then you would get an image. But for development, you could normally use a resource known as Unsplash. So what Unsplash helps you do is it has freely usable images, right? So there's no copyright thing or anything. Of course, we're making this just for a demo, so there's no copyright issues. But anyway, it's good to have, you know, a good resource to refer to for photos. Plus, it has a really, really large variety of photos, and all of them are of really good quality. Like, in, you can see this image is a really good quality image, right? So that is what we're talking about. So what we can do is we can just simply search for Harry Potter. And you can see I've taken the second image here, not very tiring. And you can do copy image address. Now, this is something that there are no copyright issues with, so we can do it easily, right? And you can just paste it here. And they have really nice short links, right? And in the alt, I can put Harry Potter image, right? So now the next thing is this paragraph right here. You could go to the blog, I'll link to it, and copy this, but I already have it here, so I'll copy this from there. So now the next is this heading, and just if it is difficult to figure it out by looking at it, this is an H4, right? So I'll copy this, I'll do an H4, and paste this. The next, I'll take my paragraph, copy that from here, and I'll paste it in here. I'll take my other paragraph, right, and I'll bring this back. I go here, I select my things, I go back, I paste it. The next is this H4. This is quite small, so I'll type it out actually. And the paragraph before jumping into the phrase, whatever. So in this video, I'm going to try to cover mostly the things that you already know, you know, with only some new things. And in the next one, we'll cover all the quite new things like the Google fonts and, you know, these kinds of things and how I put this line, although that is not quite big deal, but I'll try to focus on all those things in the next video. So now if I open this up, I can just do it here. So I see I have all my content on the page. However, it's evident that the styling is not the same and it is quite different, right? So first thing we see is that all of this is wrapped inside something which has a width which is not equal to the width of the whole web browser, and the width always remains at a good proportion, right? The proportion of this width to this width always remains the same. And to do this, you would first of all wrap all of this inside of a div, because as we know, all the similar content is wrapped inside of a div. And if I move all of this up here, so this won't show a difference right away, of course, because we haven't styled anything in the div. But now we have something with which we can refer to this. And obviously, we are going to need another other divs. So we can give this div a class of container. Now you can give a class of anything, and I'm giving container because you'll understand what the use of a container is when we study Bootstrap. it's no specific use right now, but it's just, you know, habit of giving the name container. And yeah, so visibly that's the only div that we can see right now, and we'll see that we need another div later on, but I'll just tell you for now that if you notice, this is not taking up the whole space, right? And one way you could do this is with the padding, and the other way you could do this, which I think is better because this is taking up more space than this, so you cannot have a different padding here and a different padding here, right? So how you could do this is you could wrap this content inside of another div, and then we could assign a different width to that one. So we're gonna do the styling in the next video, and for now I'll just wrap all of these in a separate div. And I open this up. And so of course I don't see a difference again because I haven't styled this div anyway. So it's still the same. But now we have a structure which we can style to get something like this, right? This is the basic structure that we need. And now we'll start the styling in the next video. And I'll see.